Hi, I'm Mike Hendrickson Dirk. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So Intel, you've been at OSCON for a few years, quite a few years. What's up with Intel and open source these days?
Well, we've been involved in open source for a decade or more, and we continue to invest in a lot of open source development projects. We have obviously projects we kick off ourselves. We're involved in some of the largest projects. We are one of the top contributors to the Linux kernel. We're involved all the way up and down the stack, and that continues. So OSCON is one of the many venues where we actually can talk to our communities, talk often to the end users, but mostly talk to developers, and that's over here.
So what are some of the cool open source projects that you guys have cooking right now?
There are too many to list them. But I mean, we show a few here in our booth. So we're working on making the developer experience more pleasant for people developing for Android. So you can see the hardware-accelerated emulator that you can use now to build your Android applications on an Atom-based image. We're showing some of the work that we're doing on the Rapid Interface Builder to make it easier to create HTML5 applications. So it's a lot of helping people to be more productive when creating open source software.
Exactly. So you also are behind the Tizen project with Samsung. Can you talk a little bit about what Tizen is?
Well, Tizen is a project that is all about the mobile experience. How can you have a truly top-notch mobile OS that is built as an open source project? And we've had a very successful conference a few months ago where we showed the first device running Tizen. And I think it's making good progress. It's whenever you come out with a project like this, everyone says, you know, where's the device? Where can I buy it? And if you try to do this in the open, it's a little challenging because you kind of let people watch how sausage is made in a way. But I think the end result will be worth it, and it will be very good to show people that you can create an independent platform that really is competitive in this market.
Competitive feature-wise, I understand, but is anyone going to catch Android and iOS? I mean, if they do, it would be someone like Intel, so...
Well, so I would like to remind you, when Android came to the market, everyone says, oh, they're never going to catch iPhone, and now they're outselling them 5-3. So I think this is a market, or this computer industry is an industry where there is never someone who owns the market and can just rest on the laurels. There's always going to be challenges and challengers coming into the market. And we've seen this for the last 25 years, and I think we're going to continue to do this for the next 25. So the place that Tizen will take in the mobile ecosystem, we'll see over the next, you know, 5-6 years, and ask me in 10 years how we did. But if you look at the different places we are going, if you look at, for example, IVI, in-vehicle infotainment, there is a wide open field there. And we see clear demand from the carriers to say we want to see other options. And as the last few months have shown, some options are beginning to fall away. So I think there is a lot of space there.
So Intel Inside has always been a term that, you know, has been associated with you guys for a long time. What inside are you going into next? I mean, have you guys been thinking about like big insides, like larger equipment or anything like that? Or
I think wherever you have computing, we see markets. So I don't think we restrict ourselves to just think of the PC or anything. It has been many, many years that we've been in everything from the largest servers to the smallest embedded devices, and that will continue. I obviously can't make any product announcements or anything here, but I think wherever you see computing happening is where you're going to see Intel.
Yes, excellent. Well, Dirk, thank you for your time, and we look forward to seeing you guys at OSCON next year.
My pleasure. Thank you.